Hello there, Mansa Priya here from Upcycled. Today I'm on Expressions Craft Studio with a simple video. This is like a basic video on how to use chalk paints, what surfaces it can be used, how it can be used, with what kind of brushes you can use. I'm going to talk all about it. This is like a very basic tutorial wherein I show you how chalk paints can be used on various surfaces. So let's get into it. Today I'm trying to flaunt all my stash of IMX chalk paints. Here I have this pink punch. This is from IMX brand. So here the bottle comes with an open lid as well as the flip flop, and all the instructions are over the label. Kindly read them, and also before using any chalk paint, always shake well. So here you can use sponges, sponge daubers, the stippling brushes, the plain brushes. If it's a large surface, you can always use a sponge spread, and then the knives. You can use a simple toothbrush to just make splatters, and you know, can do various other things, but for the basics, I'm going to show you how we can use chalk paints over various mediums. Here I'm going to demonstrate over glass jar, tin, fox leather, what do you call, canvas. Yeah. Terracotta and various other surfaces. So I'm just picking random stuff just for demonstration purposes. Here's a soft board. This is from Expressions Craft chipboards collection. These are like a group of tags wherein I picked one. So here I'm using the grape color. So I'll show you how one little dab of paint can cover a whole lot of surface and can give even coverage. So either you can use gesso to first prime the surface, or you can directly use these chalk paints. Most of the surfaces wouldn't need any priming. You can see for yourself how great coverage this gives. Just one stroke of it with very little paint and all the surfaces totally covered. So in order to show you variations, first I'm showing you darker shades wherein the coverage is great, but for certain lighter shades, maybe you would require, just maybe, not on every case, but sometimes you would need a second coat. Now I'm showing you a fox leather, you know, card holder that I have. I'm taking the lavender color here and using a brush, I'm just applying a little amount of paint over the fox leather surface. This is a little, you know, a surface with little texture. So you can see how the texture is still intact, and then it gives great coverage as well. I'm going to also show you how it looks over the metal. See, just one coat of it and it's completely done. It's that easy and great to give good coverage, and one small bottle would go a long way. Always shake your bottle before use. So now I'm taking a little terracotta pot that I have. I'm using my regular sponges and just dabbing over all the surface. In most of my projects, you would see me using these disposable sponges wherein I cut a sponge into smaller pieces and use and throw them. This is more economic for me. You can always suit yourself. So here I'm just dabbing all over the surface. If you ask me, I'll always prefer sponges over brushes on most surfaces. Unless it is very intricate and tough to go with the sponges, I use brush. But otherwise, it's only sponges, because that gives great effect. There are no lines, the paint, it goes with very little paint, and then there would be even coverage. So here I'm demonstrating over a wooden card holder wherein I've already painted it in turquoise blue, but then I would like to show how one color can be overrided with another one with no show of the other one. Like here I'm using a coral peony and then over the turquoise. So even if it is not primed, you can see how well the coverage is. I just wanted to show you how chalk paints can be used on various surfaces and how it can be used to create various looks. There you go, just a little paint and you can override over most of the colors unless it is very dark or something. That's the beauty of IMX chalk paints. They're very smooth, buttery, great coverage, orderless. And then you can see me use chalk paints all the time and they're very skin friendly as well. You can wash them with soap water. So here I'm taking azure blue and then mixing a little bit of IMX texture paste here just to show you how the chalk paint can be used to give textures using a palette knife. So here I'm taking a plastic surface and then with the help of palette knife I'm gently applying little paste of texture paste mixed with azure blue. You can create a lot of patterns, use a stencil and stencil out a particular design that you wish to. You can even use crackle paste, gessos, whatnot. You can mix these colors on everything. Even you can mix some beads or sprinkle glitz or deco stones and create various textures. So now moving on to the glass surface, I'm using the same azure blue and just tapping over the glass surface. Here, see, you don't even need gesso. Most of the times I prefer direct dabbing over the glass surface because it gives great coverage. I mean, you can see it for yourself. And coming to the blending part, if you pick two colors and blend in, the blending of these colors is an absolute stunner. You can see how easily the colors get blended, and using the sponge dabbing technique it's all the more easier. It looks so natural. You can give ombre effects, what not. You can go crazy with these chalk paints, I'm telling you. So over the lid I'm using a different color and then blending it along the sides. The lid is a metallic surface, the jar is a glass surface. You can see how versatile this chalk paint is. I can, totally assure this is one great thing that you would love to buy for your craft stash. You can never go wrong with this. So there you go, I'm just done blending it. But looking at the drying time, if you're painting it over a wooden surface or chipboard, it's way easier and it dries faster. And if it is a tin surface, that you intend to use it outdoors, then it's always good to prime it with a metal primer. Otherwise, if it's just for gifting purpose or storage purposes, you can directly use a chalk paint and either using brushes or sponge rubbers, just paint the surface. You might need more than one coat sometimes, but in this case, I've just done a single coat of this beautiful color. So I was talking about the drying time. Some surfaces, it's very easy to dry. By the time you paint the whole surface, it's almost dry. But then things like glass, tin, and other metal surfaces, it might need 5 seconds more time, 10, a minute more time than the usual drying time. But that's okay. The results are all worth it. See how just a coat can give. See, chalk paints are basically acrylic paints with that matte finish and chalky finish that you have. And IMX brand has that great consistency, that's more important. Also, the packaging part is great. It comes with a plastic lid and it's so easy to use. So that's about it. I've shown you on almost all the surfaces that I've... Yeah, okay. Here's a canvas sponge that I already painted it in some different color which I didn't like. So look how I would override this. I would use a little bit of paint with a sponge dabber and then run it. It's a beige color that I'm running it. But then again, I don't like this color as well. So what I do, once it is dry, I'll flip it and use some other colors. You can see how they can be overrided with no traces of the previous color. Every crafter must be doing this until they find their desired results. So this paint comes in very handy for people like me. So that's about it. I've shown you various surfaces and techniques that can be used. In the coming videos, I'll be showing what kind of effects can be achieved through these IMX chalk paints. I'll be teaching, I would be demonstrating crackle, distressing. You please let me know in the comment section below if you want to specifically know some kind of a technique that you would want. Also, there's a giveaway to this video. IMX brand Expressions Craft would be sponsoring few couple of chalk paints to the maximum sharers of this video. So kindly like, comment and share over the social media and do tag Expressions Craft, and two lucky winners would get some yummy colors of chalk paints. Yay! So I hope you enjoyed watching this quick demonstration. Here I'm also using an old brush. I diluted the paint with little water and then I'm just sprinkling the paint over the surface. That gives a very nice sprinkle paint effect. Also, you can cover a chipboard surface in no time. You have a great variety of chippies from IMX brand Expressions Craft, tons and tons of designs which are very versatile, and lots of designs that have come in the new releases. I hope you can check them out on the Expressions Craft website. So that's about it. I've shown you on the softboard. Look how great it is. You can do probably image transfer, and then this is on terracotta. This is the chippy that I've colored. You can just layer it and imagine what you want to do. And then this is the override that I've done on the wooden surface. This is the fox leather surface card holder that I've done. This is the tin that I've painted. This is the texture paste that I've used. And then this is the canvas, and finally this beautiful glass surface. So I hope you enjoyed watching all of this, and do let me know what more you would like to know about chalk paints. Kindly check out more on expressionscraft.in and please share. Thank you.